Two words. Daddy AF. Steven Universe the movie is not as grand as the title makes it out to be, but a decent enough watch nonetheless. To those unfamiliar, this is a TV movie that continues the story of the famous Cartoon Network show Steven Universe, which follows the adventures of a preteen boy who's half human, half gem, which is an alien race of magical humanoids powered by gemstones on their bodies, basically the same as having a human heart. Steven has three caretakers other than his father, being Garnet, Amethyst, and Pearl. They were his mother Rose Quartz's closest friends, and since she was bearing a child with his human father Greg, she had no choice but to give up her physical form to give birth to Steven, and the group falls under the name he gave for the group, the Crystal Gems, serving as a team of gem rebels on Earth. And the four of them have adventures defending the Earth from some gems who either want to cause havoc on other worlds or have come to seek revenge on certain things Steven's mother has caused in the past. Personally, when the show came out, I didn't have a huge interest in it, but I had a lot of friends who did, and after checking it out, I've been happily following it ever since its premiere in 2011. I love the animation, the colors are so peaceful and they blend perfectly together, and the music is absolutely beautiful. It's not completely void of issues, as there are quite a few episodes that seem like they're keeping us from moving the plot, and this show is unanimously known for having a controversial fanbase which instantly turns people off to the show. But here's my thing. I'm not one of those people who dislikes the show because apparently it's cool to. In fact, take the fanbase out of the equation and the show is fine. I can't have one conversation with someone about this show, whether a new episode or whatever, because people seem so concerned with talking about the fanbase. In this case, and like every case I like to make about the show, I keep the show and the fanbase distant because one does not affect the other. But enough about that, let's actually get to the movie. The film takes place 2 years after the events of the last episode, in which Steven is now 16 years old and has united gems and humans alike, and is seen as sort of the leader of this movement throughout the galaxy. Everything seems perfect until another gem shows up named Spinel, whom Pearl seemed to know as well as Rose did. She also comes packing with a giant injector which she uses to start killing all life on Earth, but Steven is left at a disadvantage when all of them, even Spinel, are struck with her weapon that seems to revert gems to their original state, which also keeps Steven from using his gem powers, so he has to use what little he has to bring the gems back to their senses whilst stopping Spinel and the injector. Okay, no more exposition. I can finally start talking about the movie. Now, going into this, I didn't know what to expect, considering after the episode preceding this movie gave hints that the show was over, and whatever this new thread is seems completely out of place to me. Upon further examination, the last episode ended the whole Rose arc that they started all the way back in 2011, and there are hints of a new series in the future. Maybe we can see what happens next time in Steven Universe Shippuden. Wow, that was an easy joke, but I digress. I'm happy this movie continues to stick with its roots to the show with the beautiful animation and music, and even more so. The show is used to having musical numbers, and this movie doesn't shy away from that, as there are several beautifully orchestrated and sung pieces that's worthy of a soundtrack purchase. Sometimes the songs can seem a little too close together and out of place, but in a way it's fitting to the show's nature. However, a minor complaint I have is with the title. The last episode, titled Change Your Mind, seemed more fitting of the movie subtext, as it seems as there is more at stake here in that special as opposed to this movie, even though the runtimes are both different. If anything, it feels like an extended episode of the show that could potentially bridge the gap between two different series, whenever we reach that bridge. Keeping in tune with the show, the movie is contagiously fun to watch. More often than not, you'll find yourself smiling wide about how pure and colorful the characters are, or even tearing up at this movie's beautiful soul. The charm that Rebecca Sugar brings to the franchise is unbelievable, all with the combined effort of the animation, music, voice actors, and overall style. No matter how you look at it, this movie and franchise can make you feel. Sometimes in ways a lot of kid shows nowadays can't, and I give props to that, unlike a lot of them, this movie expresses a lot of emotions and makes me forget why people give this show such a bad rep. I mean, I know, it's got problems, but there's so much to admire as well. Some scenes that show the movie's strengths are the ones where Steven is trying to jab the gem's memory and bring them back to their senses. A lot of these scenes are so wholesome and recount some of the great moments the series had, whether it be a love triangle or just love, which love is the overall theme of this franchise. Speaking of love, though, one of the issues I had was how little Connie was utilized in this. The commercials for this movie gave the impression that the relationship as friends was going to evolve, but it did little to nothing to do so. I mean, Steven has had a crush on Connie since episode 7, and I just want to see it blossom already. A small nitpick, but is it so wrong for me to want that? But let's get to the real meat of this special and discuss the antagonist, Spinel. Now, before I get into that, it's vital that I mention that we are entering spoiler territory, and I can't talk about her character without emphasizing that enough to you guys. So, you've been warned. Near the end of the third act, where the gems start regaining their memory, you learn that Spinel was a playmate made for Rose when she was under the alien Elise of Pink Diamond, where they played in Rose's garden. Eventually, she had to move on and made Spinell wait for her to come back, but she never did, and for that reason, she's out for revenge on Steven. Now, a constant criticism I'm hearing about the show is that they set up Rose Quartz to be this beautiful individual who cares about everybody, but in recent memory, the audience makes her out to be an awful person who is nothing but selfish, doing horrible things that she doesn't tend to give a second thought about whom it affects other than herself. And yeah, basically the same deal here. The majority of bad things that happen in the series are because of Rose's selfishness that tends to put everyone in danger, and I'm just wondering where the hell this is going. And I think this bothers me so much is not the fact that her mess always has to be picked up by her son, but the fact that they are still doing it. Change Your Mind had this one integral scene in the whole franchise.
What is this? Where is Pink?
She's gone.
What did you say?
She's gone!
And that scene says so much, saying how Rose doesn't exist anymore, only Steven, but also how this is the end of the journey for Rose's wrongdoings. Like, it couldn't get worse than that, and yet this whole movie does a whole turnaround and contradicts the whole thing, rendering it pointless. You have that beautiful closing of the Rose saga, and then suddenly, uh-oh, here's another person Rose pissed off coming out of nowhere for no reason. I feel like they forgot to work in the proper bridge between the end of the series and the beginning of another, so they made a movie out of it with a character that has no real reason to exist. That is my biggest gripe with this movie. But with all that said, what did I think of it? Well, it's about as good as I thought it would be, meaning it's not great, but I know fans of the show will mostly like it. The good that's there is still good, even if there are a lot of problems. But with all this movie offers, I see no reason to dislike it too much, as it's still a lovely piece by Rebecca Sugar, and worthy of seeing by any fan of the show. So, check it out and see for yourself. But seriously, again guys, Daddy AF, okay?